myLifeng.com. Extremamente digital, por isso. Poison to Evil, an ambassador of truth, because I always seek the truth, and the truth is the light of the world. Today I'll be talking about African spirituality. African spirituality is an ancient way of worship, an ancient way Africans to commune with nature, and it is the reason Africans are so blessed with it. In the olden days, centuries ago, our ancestors practiced African spirituality. And during that time, life was so sweet and easy. I'm telling you. I grew up with my grandfather. He's a spiritualist. In the Akaji Ofo, he was the Akaji Ofo of our ancestral temple and our village deity. He told me a lot about his young age. And I was like, why is life not easy like this now? My grandfather lived for 115 years. It was more than that, just have to bring it down. He lived that long because he practiced African spirituality. He stayed away from many foreign chemical foods. He stayed away from harmful things. He possessed only, he only used anything natural. Because he believes in African spirituality. Religion has made everything with Africa. Religion is the reason why Africa is suffering today. Religion is the reason why we are wallowing in poverty today. Religion is the reason why our children, our youth are dying at a young age today. Religion is the reason why we have been slaves to the whites. Religion stops you from thinking and stops you from asking questions. Religion enslavement is the worst enslavement, the worst slavery. It's better they put the chains on your hand and your leg and you know that you are seeing the physical chain than this chain on your head. They brought in a book written by a man to deceive Africa. I tell you that Jesus is coming soon. Before my great grandfather was born, he has been hearing Jesus is coming soon. It's only God that knows where the God that stole you from. Africans need to wake up. As an African, when you wake up in the morning, especially as an Igbo man, when you wake up in the morning, you wash your hands, wash your leg, wash your face, brush your mouth, pick up your alligator pepper, you cleanse yourself of negative energy, of evil. You thank your ancestors, thank the Most High God, thank the Mother Earth, thank your chi, thank your marine set, thank all spirit, all arrangement of spirit affiliated to you. Commit your daily activities over to them. But now, when everybody wake up, they will kneel down and start disturbing the old neighborhood. They say they are praying. They are casting, they are binding. Have you seen anyone that has been casting and been binding that is doing well today? Instead, their condition is getting worse. Because what you should know is that those spirits that you are singing, that you are binding, you cannot kill them. You cannot hurt them. They are nature entities, energies. They cannot be broken. They cannot be killed. They cannot be binded. All of them, any spirit hurting you or making your life miserable, does it under spirit permit. Does it under the Most High God permit. Because as we have spirits, we have physical court, we have spiritual court. and the judge of the spiritual court is God Almighty, Okiki, the Creator. Your ancestors are your lawyers, your witness, because they intercede on your behalf. So before an entity will disturb, that entity must be afflicted to you. Is that the entity is from your maternal home, or your father's home, or the entity is with your guardian angel? What the entity is asking for is for you to align with the energies, and offer sacrifice to that energy, because the energy was among the spirits assigned to your chi, assigned to your guardian angel to help you in your daily lives, and you starve that spirit. Starving a spirit is like starving someone from not giving someone food, you know, like that's starving a spirit, because blood energizes spirit just like food energizes humans. That's why we have to offer sacrifice, blood and animal sacrifice daily. Now look at, take for instance, a company is being run by a man filled with staffs, and the man refused to don't pay the staff salary. Maybe he has been owing them for about 3 months. All of a sudden, they'll go on strike. Some of them might go to the police. Some of them might charge the man to court. That is how it is in the spiritual. All the spirit working for us, both spiritual and physical, we are supposed to be paying them salaries, like offering sacrifice to them. And when we fail to do so, they report the case to spiritual court. The Igbos call it Nduki, spiritual tax force. And they comes to cause problem in your life. Now check a spirit that is asking for you for debt. You now went and call a pastor to go to that temple, destroy the temple. My brother, you just dug your own grave by doing that. You just made your problem worse because you provoked that energy. You have activated that energy. You have provoked the energy. Share when that energy is a feminine energy. A feminine energy don't take this life. So why some people, you see that an energy is asking for debt. Instead of you to wake up in the morning, pick up a cola, continue coming with the forces, begging them to give you time. Begging them to give you time. Begging them to open way for you. So you come and settle them. You won't do that. You start disturbing the whole neighborhood and be casting, binding, tying, pushing. By doing that, you are provoking them and your problem will be getting worse. Why can't African open? What are you scared of? Hell or hellfire? My brother, there's nothing like hell or hellfire. And I'll keep saying it. When you die, you reincarnate to continue your mission. Who has seen hell? Who has seen hell? The hell you are passing through is the one we are passing through in Africa now. Which hell is greater than that? African spirituality is the key to a black man consciousness. It's the key to connect us to nature. It's the key to light and the warrior to fight against evil. Because the two things, the major two things that is killing Africa is religion and politics. Look at children of nowadays. You see a little child, they will be dressed like a pope. And his parents will tell him that, I want you to be a reverend father. I want you to be a reverend sister. If that is what the whites brought to us, they stop us from reproducing. They tell a reverend father not to get married, a reverend sister not to get married. And I've asked myself, what is the work of a reverend father is to preach in the church. What is the work of a reverend sister in that same Catholic church? Same as some of those reverend fathers, 90% of them are getting married secretly, building mansions. That same religion, that same Catholic, especially Catholic, their society, their cults. If If you are going there, you are a secret court. That same society, I will not call it religion, that same Catholic society, when a man died in the family, they will ask you to come and do clearance. That without clearance, they won't come. Without clearance, they won't come and bury that your family member. Is that not business? It's a very good business, my man. If not that my faith forbid me into doing 419, I go open church now. They do business now. If you don't do clearance, they know who come. Come bury that person. You must do clearance before they bury that dead. Is that not a good business? And you still believe that way is the way of God. You are a foolish person. Any grown-up man is knowledge from the spirit realm. That's why I say we don't know what we are. If you look for a way to connect with the spirit realm, truth will be revealed to you. Why people are getting scared of African spirituality is African spiritualities don't have mercy. When you saw your aunt, you are practicing African spirituality and saw your aunt by killing people, or you are doing charms, or you are making charms to kill people or to hurt people, it will kill you. See that man go and strike you, or mother heads, sent karma to you. Everyone needs to go back to their way of worship. Let's join our hands together and lose the chain from our head. Let's make Africa great again. In the old world, there's an African man in the whole world. Progressing, there's no African man that won't progress. The best way for us to be strong and be great again is to wake up from religion and enslavement. Have you known your chi? Have you known your ancestors? Throw away your Bible. Throw away your Quran. Throw away all sort of religion materials, man-made materials, and embrace natural materials used to commune with nature. You can use anything to commune with nature. You can use water, you can use cola, you can use alligator pepper. You can even just commune without anything. So your guardian angel will link you to nature. You don't need any pastor to perform prayer for you. Leave that, lose yourself from that poverty you are passing through today. Make peace with your chi. Appease the spirit around you. Even though you don't have money to make sacrifice, go buy offer. If your chi is asking you for food, go buy offer. Go buy offer. Pray, commune every day on a daily basis. And your way will be open. The only way is stay out of trouble. Stay out of evil. Stay out of people's businesses. And the Most High God will bless you. Thank you for watching today's program. I'm Simeon, digital priest. And I pray everything I said today sank into your head. Just give it a thought. See, this life is a peaceful